Hey gang, welcome back to Rails New. This is a beginner-friendly series on building a real application with Ruby on Rails. And here we have our application. It's a nice little to-do app that we're calling Doable, and we've added some pretty cool features so far. We can go to a project, and in our project, we have many different to-dos, and we can also edit our to-dos, we can edit our projects, we can go to our to-dos index page. We have a whole bunch of stuff in here that's awesome. But you might be wondering, can we update the look of it? What about that nice modern UI we saw way back in that first video? Well, guess what, gang? Now is the time. That's right. In today's episode, we are going to make this app look oh so pretty by styling it with Tailwind. It's Tailwind time, baby. Let's go. Okay, first off, what is Tailwind? You see, Tailwind CSS is a utility-first CSS framework. So instead of writing custom styles in a separate file, you can apply small, reusable utility classes directly in your markup, like these ones right here, like flex, fox column, size 48, shadow XL, all of this stuff. You could think of it like stacking Lego bricks. You're not designing everything from scratch, you're reaching for little building blocks that help you move fast and consistently. Tailwind CSS is amazing and there's a ton of documentation on it, so if you want to learn more about it specifically, go to tailwindcss.com. There's a ton of stuff about it in there. Okay, so Tailwind CSS is cool and all, but how do we actually add Tailwind to our Rails application? Well, one of the most elegant things about Rails is how it handles functionality. It's all powered by gems. I mean, Rails itself is just a collection of gems. By the way, we can just go to our gem file and check it out. And when you want to add new features like Tailwind, you just add another gem. And we can do that right now. In our terminal, we can type bundle add Tailwind CSS Rails. And when that gem is installed, it gives us a new command that we can use with Rails. So we can type /bin/rails Tailwind CSS install. And that's it. There's no manual setup, no post CSS config, and no node. Just one gem and one command. All the other stuff is sort of handled under the hood by Rails itself. Now we can restart our Rails server. We go to see our project and, well, the fonts have changed quite a bit. Well, this is a preview of the Tailwind styling that we are going to see. Now, I did something behind the scenes that made these fonts change, but let me show you a little something that you need to know when using Tailwind CSS with Rails. So we started our server normally with bin rails s, and we want to change, let's say, the color of a font here. With this new project view, I want to change the color of the font from green to, let's say, gray 300. That seems pretty good. This is a Tailwind thing that we've done here. We made our text gray 300. So if we go back to our project's new view, just like this, we can see that, well, the text didn't actually change color. Why is that? That's because you're going to want to run a new command after you've installed Tailwind CSS to run your server. That command is /bin/dev. Now you might be wondering, what is bin dev? Well, bin dev is a little script that we can run that gets edited by Rails when we install Tailwind CSS to add a new program to it. If we go to bin dev, we can see here that we run foreman start with procfile.dev. Okay, so now let's go to our procfile.dev, and it's right down here. And we can see here in this procfile.dev that we actually have two different processes that are being run when we start foreman with bin/dev. This was edited by Rails after we installed Tailwind CSS. We installed a new Tailwind CSS watch command. Now, Tailwind CSS watch is going to see that we make changes to our CSS. It will then include it in the final CSS so we can see it on our page. So after we run bin dev, if we hit refresh, we can see that, yes, the color of this font has changed to a light gray. That is why you want to use bin/dev after you install Tailwind CSS and not just Rails S. Okay, so now let's just style a view that we have here. Let's style our project's show view. I actually have some styles that I'm going to just paste into this file right here because you guys don't want to watch me write down every single letter of this file here. That would be really boring. So let's just paste this in here. If we go back to our page and hit refresh here, we can see that this actually looks just a little bit better. And it's getting kind of interesting now. And I'll break down really quickly what we've done in Tailwind to actually get what we see here. Now to start off with, and this is what makes Tailwind so great, it's so easy to just sort of put this stuff into your classes and make things look a little bit better. We have text extra large on our H2 class, which is the title, which is to-dos for this project. We also have font semi-bold, text gray 800, and MB4 means margin bottom 4. Then we have our space y2 on this UL tag, which gives us a little bit of extra space on the Y axis. And then down here for every line item, we have background white, padding 4, we have shadow, it has a rounded edge to it, so we have these rounded edges here, we have a little bit of a drop shadow, flex, item center, justify between. It's super easy to play with this stuff in Tailwind, and I'm just going to go ahead and play with the rest of this app, and let's see what we come up with. And if we play around with our styling with Tailwind CSS just a little bit more, we can wind up with something that looks a little like this. This is some amazing styling that we've done in Tailwind CSS. We have this really, really nice looking view. We have a header up here with doable, and we have some links for our projects and our to-dos. We can look at our to-dos, we can edit them, we can go back to our to-dos, click on a new to-do right here, we can select our project from a dropdown up here, and this just looks unbelievable. It's really, really cool. Now, don't worry, we're going to put a branch where we have all of these stylings in the GitHub repository that we're going to link in the description below. So you can check out this styling too and get some inspiration to see how you want to style your app with Tailwind CSS. Okay, so now we've built something real. This application has a ton of features. It looks amazing now that we have Tailwind CSS, and I'm really happy with how this all works and how all these pieces fit together. But right now, you see, we have a little bit of an issue. This app is still just on your machine. It's on localhost only. You see, the internet is a connected web, and this application is just on this island all by itself, lonely. Sad, but we can fix that. In the next video, we're going to deploy this app using Kamal, a simple deployment tool, and we're gonna push this bad boy to production, baby. It's time to go public, and I'm gonna see you there on the internet with everyone else. So stick around for that next episode where we deploy this thing to the internet, and hey, thanks, nerds.